Hello, I'm Signar Baez, Principal Architect for MongoDB, and welcome to my Lightning Talk, where I will demonstrate how you can build a simple but highly effective real-time bidirectional sync between MongoDB Atlas and Google BigQuery. Both are complementary technologies. Atlas can handle the real-time operational load, serving hundreds of thousands of concurrent sessions with sub-millisecond query response, while BigQuery can provide access to other data sources in the enterprise from which we can obtain insight via complex analytics and machine learning. Let's imagine we are tasked with building a film producer advisor app. The MVP version of the app will help film producers make decisions about their movie by predicting audience ratings. The app will be used when scouting locations in the beautiful city of San Francisco while considering different directors and cast. Let's imagine our app is built on a modern architecture that follows separation of concerns, where the systems of experience, the customer experience that is powered by MongoDB Atlas. Great. Now, we all know we will need a mobile app and a backend, but that is out of scope for this talk. But in order to provide the recommendations that our film producers need, we need to unlock the value of our data located in our systems of intelligence and obtain insight by cross-referencing with our operational data in near real time. By working together, these two types of systems can enrich the operational data and elevate the customer experience. We will focus on the sync between both data stores and building a machine learning model. First, we need to duplicate data from Atlas to BigQuery. I'll use Google Dataflow as a one-time event, and let's call this the initial load. Since data for movies can change at any time, we will implement a real-time sync using MongoDB's chain streams and Google PubSub. And finally, we'll train an ML model based on ratings, cast, and locations. Okay, let's start with the initial load. First, we define our connection to the Atlas cluster. And we then define the table in BigQuery where we will write our data to. Then simply read from Atlas using Google Cloud Dataflow and transform the JSON document into a table row and eventually write into BigQuery using Dataflow. That's it, it's that easy. Here is our Atlas cluster in Google Cloud running in the Oregon region. And what's great about this demo is that all data needed is available in Atlas using the sample datasets. Now, these have already been preloaded. And here's an example of what our movie data looks like in JSON. Excellent. Everything we need is there. Okay, now let's go to BigQuery. And I've already created a dataset named mflix, and notice there are no tables. That is because the table we will use to move data will be created at runtime by Dataflow. Now, here are my Dataflow jobs. There are no jobs running. And I'll just fire off a Dataflow job on a Google Cloud VM. It takes a little bit to run, so this video has been pre-recorded. And once it is running, we can see the Dataflow job and expand to get a view into the flow of data and the various steps that are going on as data flows from Atlas into BigQuery along different pipelines, different internal pipelines. That's actually quite nice. And now let's go into BigQuery and fire off a query, and we can see that all the movies were indeed moved over from Atlas. There they are. Outstanding. Okay, let's switch our attention to the real-time sync. And to respond to data changes in real time and sync from Atlas to BigQuery, we're going to use chain streams. Now, for a larger scale integration, we could have used Kafka, as our sync and source connectors are based on chain streams. But for the purpose of this talk and to simplify the architecture, we will use Cloud PubSub and Cloud Dataflow. This Java class is acting as a CDC source connector. And in MongoDB, to respond to changes in real time programmatically, all we need to do is to call the watch method on a collection. In this case, I'm going to watch all movies. Now that sounds funny. And for each movie, this call block will fire, which itself will fire a PubSub event right here. And it is that simple. Now, here is the CDC sync connector. And first we'll define a pipeline where we consume topics from PubSub And those topics also include the message, which is the actual row of data. And since we're dealing with one record at a time here, we don't need to use data flow. We simply write straight to BigQuery using the BigQuery I/O library. Now let's insert a movie called real-time rules and ensure it does not exist in BigQuery. And now both the sync and source connectors are running in Google Cloud VMs. And let's insert this new movie. I can simply use the Atlas UI to clone an existing JSON document, remove its ID, and change its title. Here we go. And remove the ID. And let's change the title to real-time rules with one exclamation mark. Okay, perfect. And let's go ahead and insert that new document and watch on the right side, both the sync and source connectors the moment I press insert. And here we go, there, done. Incredibly fast, super fast. Now let's go into BigQuery and verify that indeed we have a new movie that that came over from Atlas to BigQuery. And there it is, perfect. Real-time rules. Now let's obtain insight by cross-analyzing data in BigQuery. We're going to use the movie location sample dataset, and that is an open and public dataset available in BigQuery. And the query that I have here analyzes the data from Atlas together with this public dataset and obtains the number of locations in the city of San Francisco that have been used in a movie. And we place that in a field called numlock. Here it is, Blue Jasmine 56 locations, time after time 48 locations, and so on. We can then write the output of this query to a new table. I'm going to call it Movie Insights. And we'll use this table to update data, or rather to drive the updates back into Atlas, which essentially is the enrichment. Now here is the sync and source connectors from BigQuery into Atlas. And as you may have guessed, we follow the same approach. We use PubSub and Dataflow to decouple and move data between two systems. But where it gets really interesting is at the point of enriching Atlas, or the operational data store. MongoDB's dynamic schema, which has been battle-tested for many years, lets you change the shape of a single document or many documents at runtime without deploying any data definition language statements. This is incredibly useful for application developers and data science teams, as over time, they can evolve new machine learning models or application features that produce new insight to drive a better user experience, advice, innovation of the products and services, etc. Now, before we enrich the data in Atlas, let's ensure there are no movies that have been enriched. We're simply going to fire a query looking for that numlock field and see if it exists. And correct, none of them exist in Atlas. Perfect. Now let's run the sync and source connectors from BigQuery into Atlas. And they take a little bit. Here we go. They'll start processing documents here very shortly. There it is. And the moment that it is complete, we can go into Atlas and verify that indeed some movies were enriched. Let's fire the same query. And there we go. Let's see, the first movie is The Jazz Singer with two locations in San Francisco, and then the movie San Francisco itself with four locations. I would expect more, but okay. Excellent. Now, how about movies that were not enriched? Basically, you know, they didn't have a match, and therefore we couldn't find any locations. Let's change the query to false, find, and indeed, many movies were not enriched. Perfect. There it is. Okay, let's add machine learning. Now, this goes beyond the real-time bidirectional sync, but still relevant to the hypothetical movie app that we're building. In the first data set, you may have noticed we only moved the fields from Atlas that were needed to find the movie locations. Now we need all the data to train our model. As such, I've changed the sync and source connectors to move all data and place them in another table called Movies Full. And we can cross-reference with the same locations data set to obtain the movie locations and create a BigQuery view. We can then use this view to train a machine learning model using AutoML tables. I've already done that up front. And I'm going to try and predict the IMDb rating. That is my target column. using the cast, director, and location. The ML UI is quite helpful in building different models. I've actually trained two, one that has all the columns and one with only those that I am interested in. I'm going to use this one to predict using cast, director, and location. Via the Google Console UI, you can then test the model using the API. Let's try Keanu Reeves as the actor, Lena Wachowski as the director, and the financial district as the location. Can anyone guess which movie this is? Right, that is The Matrix. And the movie rating prediction is in line with what you would expect from this movie, 8.6 out of 10. And for those data scientists in the audience, the console provides other interesting stats about the prediction too. But we all know we need to invoke our ML model via an API. So let's go ahead and do this. Let's invoke the same values over the API so we know it works. And there it is. Same cast, director, location, and the same prediction. Great. Now let's try another movie. Let's see if you can guess this one. We are going to enter The Talented Lady, Sally Field, directed by Chris Columbus and shot in Embarcadero Street, and the same, but also with Robin Williams. You might have already guessed, this is Mrs. Doubtfire, one of the favorite movies of my daughter. Excellent. Okay, let's wrap this up. I hope this short talk helps you visualize the art of the possible in terms of uniting systems of experience and systems of insight. You can use Google BigQuery or any other similar services together with Atlas, a general purpose, cloud agnostic, and scalable data store. Thank you so much, and I'm happy to take any questions.